श्रीमान वेंकटनाथार्य कवितार्के केसरी वेदांताचार्य वर्यो में सन्निधत्तां सदा हरि. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू एंजॉय तिरुप्पावै वर्स 21. दिस इज द 21st डे ऑफ मार्गरी मासम. सो वी आर गोइंग टू एंजॉय 21st वर्स ऑफ तिरुप्पावै. ஏற்ற கலங்கள் எதிர் பொங்கி மீதழிப்ப மாற்றாதே பால் சொரியும் வள்ளல் பெரும் பசுக்கள் ஆற்றப்படைத்தான் மகனே அறிவுராய் ஊற்றமுடையாய் பெரியாய் உலகினில் தோற்றமாய் நின்ற சுடரே துயிலெழாய் மாற்றார் உனக்கு வழி தொலைந்து உன் வாசர்க்கண் ஆற்றாது வந்து உன் அடிபணியுமா போலே போற்றி யாம் வந்தோம் புகழ்ந்தேலோர் எம்பாவாய். Here, Napinai now has informed their arrival to Kannan. And she also thinks that Mahalakshmi sent me only to ensure that the Bhaktais, the Gopika's desire will be fulfilled. That should be my objective. And while they enjoy their company with Kannan, I need to ensure be the purushakaram for between them. If I would like to be with Kannan here, then what's the difference between this place and Sri Vaikuntham? Is that why I was sent by Mahalakshmi? Thus she ponders and joins the goshti of Gopikas to wake up and appeal to Kannan together. So, yetra kalangal yedir pongi meedalippa, he says, the young girls are talking about Kannan. Oh, our Lord, please get up. You are the son of our master Nandagopan. Nandagopan magane. But Nandagopan atra padaitan magane. What is that? He is the owner of very many generous, big milk yielding cows that give incessantly enough milk, abundant milk, and they have large udders, and even if you keep large vessels below their udders and it keeps giving milk, you need to keep on in quick succession, you need to keep on replenishing the vessels because it gets filled up so fast. He is so wealthy, and that is one adjective. ஏற்ற கணங்கள் எதிர் பொங்கி மீதழிப்ப மாற்றாதே பால் சொரியும் வள்ளல் பெரும் பசுக்கள் ஆற்றப்படைத்தான் மகனே. The wealthy about his Kannan's father. Wake up. And then ஊற்றமுடையாய். You have so much involvement, engagement, interest, desire, துவரை, intense desire towards the Jivatmas, towards us. Utramudayai, towards the devotees, towards the Saranagatas. You are so much attached to us. And Piriyai, you are the primordial chief. You are Adi Moolam, you are Karana Bhutan, you are Sarvajnan, you are Sarveshwaran, Sarva Rakshakan. And Piriyai, Ulaginil Totramayan Indra Sudare Tuiladan. You are the one who is the beginning. In the beginning there was word and the word was God. He is the Karana Bhutan, Sarva Karana Bhutan. And Ulaginil Totramayan Indra Sudare Tuiladan. Matrar Unak Vali Tolaindu Un Vasharkan Atradavanda Adipaniyuma Pole. Similar to your enemies who come to you, who are conquered by you, who are tamed by you, who are transformed by you, and they come to your house and they fall for you. And that's the same way we have come to your house singing in praise of you and praising, proclaiming your greatness, vaibhavam, potriyam vandom, pugandelor, and fulfill. Please lend your ears and fulfill our desires to join this Krishna Aradhanam. That's what is the essence of the meaning of this verse. And Srimad Andavan and Srimad Arigishingar have described so beautifully, and I'm worried that I might cross over the time. However, we will enjoy as much as possible. Here, our Swami Srimad Andavan says, first they talk about Krishna, and they also say that in Ramavatara Kalam, Maharishis, Brahmanas, they can see Rama only with the permission of Vasishta and or Dasaratha. So we have not come here, the Gopika says, to see Perumal in Ramavataram. We have come here to see Perumal in Krishnavataram. And he is a cowherd boy. He is a cowherd son of Nandagopan. And Nandagopan is so merciful. So he has allowed us to be accompanied by you, Kanna. And you are Uttramudaya. You are so involved, engaged, attached and interested towards bhaktas, to protect bhaktas, to protect prapannas. And Swami Srimadandavan mentions, he says, let us see where he does. There was a king by name Bhagatattan, and he wanted to kill Arjuna. So he had a special shakti, power from Devendran to use the shakti astram. And he sent the shakti astram towards Arjuna. But Arjuna was completely fearless. He was not at all scared, because Bhagadatana sent the shakti astram. Because he was extremely confident that Krishna will save him. Why? How was he so confident? Because in Duryodhana, Duryodhana told Bhishma, Panjapantavas have seven akronishena, means seven groups of sena, or you can say 700,000 for discussion purposes. They have 700,000 sena army in Pandavas. How long it will take us to finish? He asked Bhishma, who is the army commander in chief. He says, it will take 2 months for me. Dronacharya also said, it will take 2 months for me. Karna said, it will take 2 days for you. And Bhishma said, it's not acceptable. You should know how long it will take by assessing the army of the opponent. This will facilitate us to store the food items, the weapons, the arms and all that. And that is what we need to plan for 2 months or 4 months. On the Pandava side, Yudhishthira asked each one how long it will take to finish the Kaurava Sena. Kauravas have got 1.1 million army folks. How long it will take? So Drishtadyumna, the Senadipati, he said 2 months. Bhima said 4 months. Satyaki said 7 months. Arjuna said, I will take the bow and I will take within half a second if Krishna is with me. Half a second. And because of the unconditional Mahavishwasam on Krishna, he thought he can do anything in the world. So that's why the Shakti Astram, when it came, he was not at all bothered. So Krishna was so pleased with that. What he did, he took the Shakti Astram on his chest. Krishna took the Shakti Astram on his chest and it got dissolved. At night, Bhishma went and met Krishna, and he said, you should not be so partial and favorite towards Arjuna. Just because for the sake of Arjuna, you hurt your Pirati Mahalakshmi on your chest. How dare you could hurt her with the Shakti Astra? You have wounded her, Bhishma said. That's Krishna. He would go to any extent to protect this bhakta. And the second incident given by Srimad Andavan. Mahabharata Yuddham is finished almost, and only Duryodhanan is there now. And Duryodhan is so angered by so many 99 brothers of his have been finished. So yes, he has controlled his breath and went into the waters to do Jalastambam. He went into the pond, immersed himself in the pond, controlled his breath, and he is doing his tapas to get the power so that he would come out and simply create havoc on Panja Pandavas. And that's what he wanted. He took a sankalpam and he went inside the pond. So Krishna now is worried how to now protect the Pandavas. So he called Dharmaputra, our Yudhishthira, and said, completely scold and abuse Duryodhana in unparliamentary words. When he hears that in the water, he would come out with such anger. He will break his woe to be inside. And so that we will win. Yudhishthira said, with my mouth, I will not scold anyone. I'm sorry. Bhima said, come on. He asked Bhima to scold. And Bhima was extremely pleased. He started in a very unacceptable word. He started scolding. And this warrior Duryodhana came, he could not tolerate anymore. So he came out breaking his woe, and that tapas was destroyed. So he came out. Now he said, Yudhishthira said, immediately, you can fight with any of us, any one of us. Any one of the five of us. And if you win, we will go back to Vanavasam forest again. And now Krishna is again in confused state. How to protect? So, if Duryodhana fights only against Bhima, he will get killed. Because Bhima is so strong. Others, because of his penance so far, perhaps, and his anger, perhaps Duryodhana will win. So, in order to tempt Duryodhana to fight only against Bhima, what to do? So he told Duryodhana, Yudhishthira, the eldest brother has told you can fight with anyone. Now I'm giving you a suggestion, Duryodhana. Please fight with either Nakulan or Sahadevan or Arjunan or Yudhishthira. Then only I think you have a better chance of winning. Now, because these four do not know wrestling, only Bhima knows wrestling and you know wrestling. You are better. So now at least you have to win. That's what you are thinking, right? So go ahead and take any other four, but not Bhima. So that's the psychology and tactics which Krishna played. So do not lose this opportunity, Duryodhana. Fight with Nakulan, Sahadevan, Arjunan or Yudhishthiran, but not with Bhima, because Bhima is as strong as you. So Duryodhana got such a rosham. He was so angered that no way, Krishna, I will fight only with Bhima. And he started fighting, having the wrestling. And Bhima kept on fighting with him, but could not kill Duryodhana. So immediately Krishna went and whispered to Bhima, hit him on his thigh. And that's where his weakest point. And Balaraman immediately told Krishna that you are not doing the right thing. You should play a fair game. How can you help Bhima? He said, Duryodhana has got a curse that only on his thigh, if somebody hits, he will win. So that's why I wanted to help Pandavas. So Balarama could not accept that. So he left that place in anger. Anyway, that's besides the point. So this is the way Krishna protected. So Uttramudayai. And now the inner meanings given is Uttramudayai Periyai. Uttramudayai, the Lord who is magnanimous in forgiving the doshams of the one who performed Sharanagati, even if they had committed such asahya pacharam earlier. Our Lord is so intense on removing this dosha. He is Periyai, the one towering above everyone. He has the rare combination of compassion, dayai, as well as the power, the shakti. One who has got power is generally arrogant. He does not have mercy, daya, and he has got both. And without the combination of daya and shakti, all efforts at rakshanam will be unfruitful. So daya or shakti alone cannot do. Both have to be there. Ulahinil totramai nindra shudar. He took the avatar, Ramakrishna avataram, and that Vibhava avataram, and that is what is Totramai Nindra Shudar. And next is Pirandai, Uttramudayai. Here the Uttramudayai is referred by Swami as Paravasudevan, Jagat Srishti. Periyai refers to the Vyuha Rupa Emperuman. Ulahinil refers to the Vibhava avatarams like Matsya, Kurma, Varaha, Narasimha, Vamana, Parasurama, Rama, Balarama, Krishna. All these avatarams, Vibhava avataram, Ulahinil, Nindra, Archavataram at the temples, Divyadesams, Shudare, Antaryami Rupam, in Jyoti Swarupa Rupam, inside us, who is indweller in our heart, and Matrar, Matrar Valitolaindu Un Vasharkan is yet another beautiful, because Vaidika Chatru, we have abandoned all Laukika, Vaidika Chatru, the enemies, such as Dehatma Abhimanam, Swatantriya Abhimanam, Devatantra Abhimanam, attachment to Bandhus, and sought you alone as the Upayam. Matrar, because of our Sharanagati. And Matrar Valitolaindu Un Vasharkan, the inner meaning is, we, the gopis, who had ego earlier about our physical beauty, are now defeated by your wonderful, majestic, exquisite, Divya Anga Lavanya Saundaryam. And that is, and Kalyana Gunams, we are enslaved by that. And we have now sought Saranagati at your lotus feet in all humility. Adi Paniyuma Pole, just as your enemies get transformed and fall at your feet, being defeated either by your Trimeni Arage or by your arrows or by your transformation, like this Kakasuran, we have fallen at your feet after being defeated by your Kalyana Gunam, by your beauty, Drishti Chitta Paharina, and Potri Yam Vando, we have come to your doorsteps. Palla singing Palla and singing divine names, Nama Sankirtana, and the stage is set to approach the lotus feet of the Lord, Pallikattin Kire, and that is what we are going to talk about tomorrow. Kavitarkika Simmaya Kalyana Gunashaline, Srimate Venkateshaya Vedanta Gurave Namaha. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Andal Thiruvadigale Sharanam.